Hello, welcome to this channel Gain Java Knowledge. And today in this video we will learn about how to change log level dynamically in our Spring Boot application. For this there are multiple ways to change the log level dynamically in Spring Boot application. But today in this video we will just create a REST API to change the log level in our application. In our previous logging with Spring Boot application video, we have already discussed about logging level and how to implement logging in our Spring Boot application and why we need logging. That we have already discussed in this video, logging with Spring Boot. And I have given the link in description. As we know, default logging level in Spring Boot application is info if we are not providing any logging level in our Spring Boot application, then by default it will be enable info. And this is the trace, debug, info, warn and error, lowest to highest log level. If we have enabled log level as info, then the log message will be printed on console, will be info type, warn and error. These three will be enabled if we have enabled log level is info. So X4 visible. If the log level is info, then we can see info message, warn message, error message and fatal message on console or in file. And if we have enabled log level is debug, then fatal will also be printed, error will also be printed and warn message will also be printed and info message will be printed and then debug message will also be printed. If the log level is debug, then these five will be printed on the console or in file. So this is the visibility graph of log levels. Okay, let's see in the code how this log level works and how we can change dynamically log levels. So this is my Spring Boot application and here I have just created one controller, that is message controller, and in this message controller I have just created one API, and in this API I have just printing the logs, logger.info and logger.warn, logger.error, logger.debug, logger.trace. So I am just printing these all logs in our Spring Boot application. So here I will go to my application.properties file. So here I have not defined anything about logger level. So by default the info level will be enabled. And if the info level is enabled, then info message, warn message and error, these three will be printed on console. As we know, by default log level info will be enabled. So now I will run this application and then we will check the console. So on console we will see info, warn or error. These three will be printed on console. So now our application has started. Now I will go to browser and here I will just type localhost 8000 message. So open console to check log messages. So here we can see on the console the log messages was printed. Here we can see just info, warning and error. These three log message was printed because the priority of warn or error is less than info. So these three was printed. Here in on chart we can see if info is enabled, then warn, error and fatal, these also will be printed on console. So now the requirement is I want to change the log level but without restarting the server. This is the main purpose of today's video. So now what I will do, here I will go to my application.properties and if I will enable this and here I will change the log level from info to debug. So it means now the log message will be printed, that is fatal, error, warning, info and debug. These five will be printed on console. So now I will hit this REST endpoint again without restarting the server. So first I will clear these log messages and now I will hit again. So here now I will go to console, and here we will see these three was printed only, because without restarting it is not working, that we have done here in our application.properties. If we want to load these changes, we need to restart the server. So now I will stop it and run it again. Now our application has started. Now I will clear it. Now I will again hit this rest endpoint, and now we will see debug level has enabled. But to enable the debug level, we need to restart the server. But the requirement is, without restarting the server, how we can change the log levels. So for this, we need to create one rest endpoint. So here I will create one more controller, that is log controller. New class, log controller. So this class will control the log level and change the log level dynamically in our Spring Boot application. So here I will define rest controller, because we are going to create one rest endpoint that will change the log level dynamically. So here I will stop the server. Now here I will create one more package, new package, that is service package. That will be the interface that will contain all interfaces. And now I will refresh it. And here I will create one more package, that is service implementation. And here I will create class, that is new interface, that is log service. And here I will create the class to implement this interface, log service IMPL. That will implement log service interface. And here I will just define at the rate service annotation to generate the bean for this class. And now I will go to our log controller, and here I will create one rest endpoint, and here I just need to auto void our log service. And here I will just create get mapping one rest endpoint, and the URL will be change log level private public string change log level. Here I have already created this rest endpoint, so here I will just paste it. And here you can see I have using get mapping, and this is the URL. And here I have defined the public string change log level function, and here I am just passing two parameters, that is logger name, that will be root or any package name that we can pass, and second one is level. Both are optional parameter. And here I will create set log level function in our interface, and now I will go to its implementation class. So this is logger service implementation, and here I just need to add unimplemented methods. So to implement this dynamically changed log level, we just need to add one dependency. So now I will go to my pom.xml that we have defined here, and in my pom.xml we just need to add this dependency. This is the dependency that we need to add if we want to change dynamically log levels. So this is logback classic chqs logback is the package. Now I will go to my controller, and here I will go to its implementation. So here what I need to create, first we need to create get the logger, and after getting the logger we just need to set the level of log level that we want to enable dynamically. So here I have imported these messages. So here these methods that we need to add also. So these are the private methods. So here I have just added, and now he is asking for import this library cell4j logger factory. And now we have done. So here we can see in set log level function what we did here. First we get the logger, and inside get logger we will pass the logger name. If you are not passing from our request URL, then it will by default set as a root level. And if we are passing any package name, then it will be set the package name as logger name, and the log level will be set only in the same package. If you are not passing anything, then it will be the root level. And in the second function, that is after getting the logger, we will just need to set the log level. What level we want to set, that is info, debug or fatal, which one we want to enable. So in this function, that is set log level, we are just passing the level. And if the level is info as a string we are passing, then log level info will be enabled. And if we are passing debug, then debug level will be set as default. And like this we can set any level. So here we can see the log levels. These are the log levels that we have implemented in our code. So if we are not passing anything in our level value, then by default all will be set as a log level. That is the else condition. So then all logs will be printed, info, debug, warn, trace, error, off. This but off is just need to off the logs, then no log will be printed if off will be enabled. So now what we will do, we will just run the application and check the log level is changing dynamically or not working. So now I will just run our Spring Boot application, and after that we will check. So this is the URL change log level. Now we can see here our application has started. So first what I will do, by default we know in our application dot properties which log level we have implemented. We have implemented log level as debug. So now we will clear this console and hit the rest endpoint. So here we can see the debug message, error message, info message was printed on console. But if I will enable the log level as info, then debug message will not be printed because its priority is low. So we can see here, if we have enabled info, then only warn or error message will be, three message will be printed on console, but debug will be disabled. So now what I will do, I will call this rest endpoint that we have created to change the log level dynamically. So now I will go here, and here I will just call localhost 8080 change log level. If you are not passing any parameter, then by default logger level will be set as all, means all message will be printed on console. So now here I will again hit this rest endpoint. Now our logger level all as set. So now fatal, error, warning, info and debug and trace all will be printed because our logger level is all. So now I will again go to console, and first I will see here all are activated, and there is, we can see all log messages going to print, that is debug, info, everything was printed. So if you want to stop this log, then what I will do, here I will go and just define the optional parameter value level is off. So here we can see logger level set as off. Now I will go to console, and there will be no log printed because our logger level is set as off. So I want to change again the logger level and I want to enable logger level as info. Then what I will do? I will pass the parameter value as info. And now we can see here the info is enabled. Now I will hit this rest endpoint and check the logs. So here I will go to post our console and here I can see the debug warn and error message printed. Here we can see we have enabled the log level as info, but on console we can see here it's printing debug error and warning message also. For this, what we need to do? We just need to disable this property and stop the server. I think there is no need to stop the server. So here I will just run this application again. Yeah, because if you want to reload application.properties file, then we need to stop the server. So here our application has started, and as we know, by default, log level info is enabled. So here when I will hit, then we can see console, and here we can see warning error and info message was printed on the console. So now I will clear it, and now I will change the log level as debug, and here I will again check the console. And here we can see we just need to hit this rest endpoint, and here we can see log one info message was printed, but the debug level as log was not working. And here now we can see the log level debug is enabled. And debug message was printed here. Debug. These all are the debug level logs. And if debug level is enabled, then info message will also be printed, and warning and error message will also be printed. So what I want to do, if we just want to print only our, if we want to stop this log, then what we need to do? We just need to set as off. And here log levels are off at root level, so no log will be printed more. So if we just want to print our only our application log levels, then we just need to pass here logger name value, logger name value of our package, then it will enable the log level in same package. So here I will go to my application. And here I will go to my class that is Spring Boot, and here just I will copy this package, and now I will clear it, and in browser I will just define the logger name, means in which package I want to enable debug level log. So here I will enter, and here just I will define debug. So now I will go here and hit this rest endpoint and go to console and check the logs. Now the debug level logs was just enabled in our application package. So like this, in any package we can enable debug info level log levels. So okay, that's it. Thanks for watching this video.